Hey guys, and welcome back to the one and only All-Stars Tower Defense. So they did an update which added like a character I really like, Kirito. And I have been logging in every hour, literally every hour. I set an alarm on my phone for every hour and he's still hasn't appeared in the summoning system yet. So right now, what we got in the summoning system is Frieza, Emilia, which is cool, and some other characters I don't care about. I did do some grinding though, and we got four characters in my main team. We got Emilia, the Demon Slayer guy. No idea who he is, but he was like the rarest rarity, so why not? We got Bulma, which is basically your money tower. So in Tower Defense Simulator, think your farms. In Tower Heroes, think your lemonade cat. And Toga. And oh my god, Toga is amazing. She does so much damage. She literally carried me throughout the game. It is insane. So today, I really want to put my focus on Toga. Show you guys how amazingly good she is. And how she can carry you through like most of the game. It is absolutely insane. Without further ado, let's jump straight into a match. I am gonna be completely honest. You know what I'm really scared of? I haven't lost a game since I have gotten Toga yet. And I just feel like now that I'm recording that I'm gonna lose. Just because like the game just wants to be like, haha. So what I normally do on this map, like, I like it when the enemy comes to you. So I don't like to spam my enemies here. I like to spam them all the way at the back, which is risky because if they come through, you lose. So we're gonna spend one Toga here, which is gonna kill most of the enemies. So I probably wanna put around 3 or 2 level 1 Togas, then set up a money farm, then upgrade some Togas to level 2, and then spam a lot of level 1 Togas. If you use Toga, you will see that upgrading her versus placing more is normally not worth it. So at the start, I highly suggest you to just place a bunch of level 1s. I also got this nice sitting emote because, like, you know, with my strategy, you gotta wait a while before the enemies come. So, you know, you can just sit down, relax a little bit. Why not? So we got enough money for a second Toga, which we're gonna place right here. And you know what you can see about my method? In this time, the enemies of wave 1 are still here. They still haven't arrived at my units yet. And that's what I mean. When you wait until the units come to you, you can actually save up a little bit more money and start off with a stronger push. And now they're just gonna get destroyed. Absolutely destroyed by the Togas. They aren't gonna get one shot, but they got the bleed effect, so they will just bleed out. I'm gonna place my first money tower here. There you go. I usually want to upgrade her to level 2 as soon as possible, because at level 0 she is absolutely garbage. Like, absolutely garbage. So usually what I do is I let these Togas kill the enemies of wave 2, upgrade Bulma to wave 2, and then upgrade one of the Togas. It's a little bit risky, but sometimes you just gotta be a little bit risky to get the best rewards, right? Okay, so as you can see, it asks me to skip the wave, and I'm actually gonna wait for that. We can actually take this damage, easy peasy. We're just gonna take the damage. First, we're gonna upgrade her, and then we're gonna skip the wave, just to get a little bit more money. They actually died of the bleeding effect. That's how strong the bleeding effect is. It's absolutely insane. I love it. And because of the fact that Bulma gave us some money, we already could have placed down our third Toga. So what I want to do now is upgrade one Toga to level 1, just because we want to be able to hit the powerful enemies, because else they will sneak through. So I really like to upgrade the one like in the corner. So there we go. And will this one bleed out? I think he will. He does. So the bleeding effect is really nice, as you can see. So now that I have one level 5, what I usually like to do is just get all 8 of my togas out, because like the place limit for toga is 8. So as you can see, I can skip the wave right now, but I am waiting because I want to upgrade my Bulma before we hit the next wave, because that way we get more money back from her in total, which that's always useful. So because of that, we could place 2 more togas, and now we placed all 8 of our togas. And now comes the first thing. The thing that makes Toga so overpowered is her final level. Her final level is absolutely insane. So usually what I like to do when I place all 8 togas and upgrade my money tower to around this level is get this toga here at the corner to max level as soon as possible. But max level is quite expensive, costing 2.3k. So you gotta watch out with that. Okay, so we acquired enough money. So let me upgrade her and watch this. Look how fast she is. Step. That. It is absolutely insane. It is so fast. And like at the begin waves, it is almost unbeatable. It is absolutely insane. And the fact that this one toga is basically carrying the entire match allowed me to upgrade the Bulmas to level 4, which is absolutely insane. And now that we got her to level 4, we're just gonna pick a random toga from the row. So let's say this one. And now we're gonna focus on upgrading her to the maximum level. So we're gonna upgrade him to maximum level one at a time, because a max level toga is way better than 5 level 3 togas. It is absolutely insane. You wanna get her to max level as soon as possible. So we got 3 max level togas now, and as you can see, the enemy isn't even getting past the 2 of them. So like the togas in their back, the only reason why they are there is for the boss. That's the only reason. It is so insane. Also, remember that when you hit wave 15, you actually sell your money towers because they become completely useless, and it allows you, bam, upgrade number 4. Maybe we can also upgrade the 5th one all the way, but I'm not quite sure. We actually could. So we got 5 max togas right now, and like 1 level 3, just for the fun of it. We might be able to upgrade her to max level before the boss comes out, but I doubt it. Maybe. It's like a case-to-case scenario, depends on the stage. Look at this, dude. It's literally a paper shredder. It is so insane. They walk in and brrr. Also, for some reason, the enemies are a little bit like rubber banding and lagging. No idea why. So it gets a little bit weird, but at least all the damage calculations are done on the server. So even if they lag past a toga, they will still take the damage. It's just visually on your end. Okay, so they come a little bit more into the paper shredder, and we can actually make our 6th max level toga. Absolutely insane. I'm gonna try to upgrade this one as high as possible too, but I don't think we will make another max level. If we make a 7th max level, I will be very surprised. Paper shredder. Amazing. Ah, damn it, dude. We need like 1,000-ish more to upgrade her to max. And unfortunately, we don't have that, because the only thing left is this guy. Jirobo the boss. Is he a clown? I have no idea what he is. But he is coming to the paper shredder, and he is gonna get absolutely destroyed. Oh, here he goes, look at his HP! And now we hit all 4, and there goes his HP! HP! Yeah, there we go, paper shredder, and he is down. Easy. That's how easy it is. Toga is an absolute monster unit. It is insane how powerful she is. I love it. I absolutely love it. It's so strong. So yeah, that was basically what I wanted to show about Toga in All-Stars. She's an absolutely fantastic hero. And to be honest, she really improved my playstyle. Like, I was really stuck on some stages, and then when I pulled Toga, I went up, like, zoop! And she isn't even maxed yet. We can still feed more units into her and make her stronger. I have no idea what the max level is. Maybe it's 50, maybe 100, maybe it's unlimited. I have no idea yet. But for now, I'm just gonna get everything that I own that isn't something I wanna use. I'm just gonna feed to Toga and just power her up like crazy, because damn, dude, this is absolutely insane. But anyway, guys, thank you all so much for watching. If you like this video and want to see more, please hit that like and subscribe button, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!